The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Makes it to the 34. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. That brings up second and 1. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Three down.
31's the mic.
Go! Go!
Run. Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
That'll make it second and 4.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Three down.
31's the mic.
And down he goes, around the 49-yard line.
They picked a good time to go with that call. It didn't seem like the defense was ready for it, and they'll move the chains.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47. And he tackles him hard at the 38.
That brings up second and 1.
He's tackled at the 37.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That'll make it.
They'll line it up again on third down. Taken down right around the 26-yard line.
This kind of execution from an offense can really affect the defense in their psyche. That's the second time on this drive alone they've been able to convert on a third down. This defense has got to be able to kind of gather themselves and try to find some confidence. And somebody on that defense has got to be able to make a play to slow this offense down.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 26-yard line, second down. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line. This is the 11th play of this drive. Receiver.
Good effort there by the receiver, but just not enough room for him to get a foot down in bounds.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Pittsburgh is looking to go up by 3. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. West Virginia's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two. And they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact they can throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
After a decent run up the gut, and he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
And he shoved out of bounds around the 43-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. He's hit and taken down.
First down.
And he's tackled at the 47.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Quick pass. There was a defender right in his face that time.
Yeah, but great concentration by the receiver to come away with this ball. Nice job.
First and 10.
Quick throw. They'll bring him down right around the 28-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Pressure got to him, and he put it on the ground. Recovered by the offense. And they hit him in the backfield.
And they're lucky to retain possession of the ball there.
This is the 10th play of the drive. Looks to him again, complete. He's taken down at the 30. An exciting first quarter comes to an end. The Panthers with a 3-point lead. We welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. West Virginia is down 3 and looking to tie it up. It's up, and it's good.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
And this one's knotted up at 3. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Slings it. Knocked out of bounds at about the 31.
That'll make it second and 4.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
You must be getting tired of seeing me. Since it's four.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. He's got the corner, and now he's got room to run. Tackle made at about the 47-yard line. From their own 47-yard line, first down. stop the 37-yard line.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle with the line of scrimmage there. That makes it second and
14. It's second down now and 14 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. Caught, open field. He's knocked out of bounds around the 32-yard line. Call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Pittsburgh could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and he just drilled it from long range. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Brought down around the 23-yard line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
From their own 23-yard line. Second down. Tackle around the 37-yard line.
Number 24 brings him down the 37-yard line. First down.
Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's level at midfield.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
He gets rid of this one. Second and 10. Ball on the 50. Through his hands.
That brings up third and 10.
And he's knocked down immediately after the catch.
That makes it first and 10.
Down he goes at the 19-yard line.
Gain of 14 on the play. First down.
He steps out around the 16-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. The 10. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
Number 25 on the tackle at the 6-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
Go! Go!
touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes, so kudos to the quarterback. He makes the PAT. An 11-play, 75-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay. The Panthers will use their first time out of the half. About 2 minutes before halftime. And he'll lose yardage.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
Gets to that quickly, and he's immediately tackled. The 49. First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. They try to get a head start there.
Ball start. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Gets out to around the 48. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8.
That'll make it second.
Second down and 7. Ball on the 48-yard line. And a quick throw, and he's taken down at about the 43-yard line. Pittsburgh's going to have to use their second time out of the half. And this may be fourth down territory if they can't get a first down here. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. He needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. And so now the ball's turned over on downs.
The offense tried to run right by him with the counterplay, but the defense was there to make the stop. Great hold, guys.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. West Virginia is up 4. Throws it in a hurry, and he's tackled right around the 48-yard line. That last pass was good for maybe 5 yards.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
Woo! This defense not wanting to give an inch here.
Touchdown, West Virginia.
Strong run by the halfback to get into the end zone.
He's a pretty sure bet to get six when you're this close to the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. A four-play, 54-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
Ready?
Looks left, picked off. Got an opening to the 10. Touchdown, big play.
And that was a super play by the defender. Excellent interception and an even better return for the score.
Converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
They'll bring him down at the 26.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
We've got a second and nine here. Ball on their own 26. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. 24-6, Mountaineers.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. The paper, the stats, all the previews say this game should be even. It's not even at halftime. In fact, it looks as if this squad just got pushed around. They got bullied out there in the first half.
One team's playing big boy football, the other team's playing peewee football. I mean, it's definitely been, it's been surprising to watch, but at some point, you just got to man up. I mean, you got to say enough's enough, and you got to respond because you had opportunities in the first half, and every single opportunity, big boy football kept winning. And some, you got the little guy's got to make a play. I mean, you can only get pushed around so much and not respond to it. And right now, it's just been disappointing to watch.
That's going
to
do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Brought down at the 22.
Well, this is one of those days when everything is clicking for an offense. These guys have been executing, and that's the reason they have such a nice lead.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. He's taken down around the 21-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 21-yard line. He throws it. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
he's hit immediately. Wide open receiver, and it's incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 41. Zips it to the back. Tackle made at the 36.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 35.
Out to the receiver, and it's knocked away.
The quarterback has to be very careful, Brad, of throwing the football into a position where the wide receiver has a chance to get his head taken off. He threw the ball there, and it made it easy for the defender to be able to separate him from the ball.
It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. West Virginia kicked this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And they can forget about returning this one. The Mountaineers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll drop in for a loss.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it. The back didn't have any room to run.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 22.
Larry. 30 was the mic.
Hey, tighten down. There you go.
Motion.
64.
Motion. 64.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That'll bring up third and long.
Tight right.
Three down.
Here we go. Watch seven.
Take off.
Seven.
Do what you have it. Take off.
Squeeze.
Crash. Setting up blockers or running backs. Got it on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 31. The offense didn't appear to be in sync on that series.
That makes it fourth and four.
Booming kick. And he's tackled at the 30. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
Well, the defense held him to 3 on their last possession. Pitching a shutout on this drive would be even better. Short pass, middle of the field. And they make the stop around the 38-yard line.
Brings up second and one.
Makes it out to about the 49.
That makes it first and 10.
Fires out to his receiver. He goes out of bounds at the 45.
That'll make it second and four.
Fires it quickly. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. There's another.
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Well, that had to be a miscue of some kind or a mental error by the defense. This wide receiver was just too open for there not to be some kind of mistake by the defense. I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense on the sideline to make sure everybody's on the same page.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. Pittsburgh's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down and they're forced to punt. Or drive ends up stalling on a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in a game like this. Throw the ball downfield and hope that your receivers can make some plays.
Knocked out of bounds, right around the 34. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
He's going to try and scramble. Tackle around the 42-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 42. And down he goes around the 47-yard line.
Number 25 on the tackle at the 47-yard line. That brings him second and 5.
Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Third and 5 coming up. Ball on the 47-yard line. Gets it quickly to the tight end, but it's dropped. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Talk about a booming punt. My goodness.
Again, it's about stressing special teams. That is why a lot of head coaches usually run these units. It's because field position is just so important in the game.
West Virginia comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Throws complete and he's hit right away.
That'll make it second and 4.
He's out of bounds. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
And he hits him hard at the 31.
That'll make it second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
Watch seven. Watch seven. Hey, let's get off the field, D. Let's get off the field, D.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down right around the 38-yard line. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
This one is a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging. Catches it, and he's looking for more.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
We head into the fourth quarter in a game that's never been close. The Mountaineers lead 34-6. Just about set to start the fourth quarter, mercifully. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's shoved out of bounds right around the 30. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30. Makes it to the 41. And he's taken down right around the 42-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second.
From their own 42-yard line. Second down.
Three down, three down.
Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike 47.
Take go.
Alert, alert, alert.
Inside handoff. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Game seven. That'll bring up third and two.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. From the 45-yard line, first down. Catches it, and that's all.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision-making.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Picked up by the quarterback, and he's tackled right around the 48-yard line.
There you go.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35.
You ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing.
Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Let's go. Let's go.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Nice play, baby, nice play. Gaining 5 on the play. That makes it 4th and 8.
Tight right, tight right.
Three down, three down.
Take go.
Check Mike. Lock it in. Check Mike.
Take go.
Makes the catch, and look out. They'll bring him down at about the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, it's first down. And they get the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere.
That'll bring up third and long.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 23.
Three down, three down.
Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike 47.
And they got him.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The Mountaineers have been about as impressive as you can be in a football game.
Wow, this is as good as it gets. The defense is playing great. The offense has done their job. We've got a blowout here.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. He's out to the 30. He makes his way to about the 38.
He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. Under a minute left in the game.
Let go. 629. Let
go. Makes it out to about the 50.
That makes it first and 10.
And he's level at the 42. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
So it's 2nd down and about 2 yards to go. This one's in the books. The Mountaineers take this game 34-6. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
Well, this rivalry game didn't live up to the hype this year. There's pure gratification on one sideline and sheer disappointment on the other. You can bet that the loser in this one will have this date marked in red on their calendar for next year.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.